So 0, Jack Bell in goal. Number 3, Herman Manzent. And number 4, Raul Fernandez. Number 7, Fade or Akanu. Number 9, Marcos Villa. Number 10, Will Overberg. Number 21, Luis Ferrero. Number 24, Javier Pastor. Number 25, William Valentine. Number 28, Ramizzi Oro Akundo. And number 39, Jose Jimenez.
And in goal, number 0, Jack Bell.
And now for Loras.
The Loras are led by head coach Chris Garcia Pratt.
For Loras, number 5, Jared Block. Number 6, Felipe Ramirez. Number 7, Alex Bosole. Number 8, Kevin Kuchaba. Number 10, Reed McClavick. Number 11, Jose Cardenas. Number 13, Michael Kay. Number 14, Taylor Sowell. Number 23, Michael Brandt. And number 32, Ryan Basinger. And coached by Stephen McCarthy in his third season, looking to go back-to-back as the Loras PA is announcing the starters for Loras. Gonna get this game on. And as we all know, Luther did win 6-0. So let's see right after these announcements.
A senior midfielder from St. John's, Illinois. Number 8, Kevin Kuchaba. A junior forward from Frankfort, Kentucky. Number 10, Reed McClavick. A senior defender from Eugene, Oregon. Number 11, Jose Cardenas. A sophomore midfielder from Rockford, Illinois. Number 13, Michael Cusa-Hernando. A freshman forward from Rockford, Illinois. Number 14, Taylor South. A senior midfielder from Indiana, Iowa. Number 23, Michael Brett.
Regarding race that exists in our conference. We will never tolerate racism, prejudice, discrimination, and hate. We stand and fight for equality, justice, opportunity, inclusion in order to make sure all students in our conference feel safe, welcome, and represented. We encourage you to stand with us and engage in conversation, get involved, and do all that you can so we can bridge the gap to social and racial justice.
And we're off on the men's game. Loras, as we know, lost a blowout 6-0 to Luther last time they played here in the Rock Bowl, but different times, and now they are fighting both for an ARC championship game. Let's start off with Luther, coming in at 11-3-5, undefeated in the conference, 4-0-4. And Luther College had a demanding win over Simpson 4-1 in Decorah, and now on the verge of an ARC championship victory. And now for the Duhawks, 10-5-2, 5-1-2, and they are the ARC champs, number one seed. And they won another commanding win over Nebraska Wesleyan here in the Rock Bowl, 4-0 on Wednesday night. So now the women won, and now it's up to the men to sweep for Loras here in the soccer programs. And third year, Stephen McCarthy told me in an interview this week that he wanted Luther and he wants to play them because he knows his men can play better than they did last time. And they can. They, you know, they won the ARC regular season champs. They can play well, and we'll see here today how it is as a throw-in by Luther. The big stars in the front, Reed McClavick, Kevin Kuchaba, and Taylor Sowell, while the man in the middle, Jose Cardenas, and Felipe Ramirez, and also Michael Brandt and Jared Block. Jared Block had two goals last game. One off a header, and I believe, and one off the left foot. Alex Bosolai getting a start in this lineup. He's in and out. I think he's in the spot for injured senior Kyler Donovan. And so getting a start right off, header by Bosolai in the back line. Loras playing a, looks like a five deep back there, just kind of letting Reed hang loose out there, letting it do his thing. They call him Showtime for a reason, so he shows up in these games. He loves these games, he said. And getting a shot. And we all know last year he had a 1-0 victory versus UD. Him scoring the lone goal in that game. And he wants to get in the back of the net today. I would say this evening. As the sun has set it, nighttime in Dubuque. Still cold. But we play on. No rain in the forecast, it looks like, so we'll be hopefully dry for today's final game here at Loras College. We had a football game earlier. UD came out victorious versus the Duhawks in the Key City Clash, and then Loras College women's team took care of business in the ARC Championship game, and now the final game of the evening, the men's game. As Luther has it in the Duhawk territory. That's the key of the game today for the Loras College men's team. Get them out of there. Don't let them take control of the game. Don't let Luther's top scorers take over like they did last game when they played here a couple weeks ago. Big guys up front for Luther, Marcos Villa, Luis Oliveira, Will Overberg, all had goals in that 6-0 win. And Villa with the chance. Jared Block getting it out of there, but Luther has a chance and a shot. Blocked by Basinger. Felipe kind of defending him at the 20-yard line. Luther trying to start off fast like they did last time. But Duhawks not having it. They will have a goal kick for the first time today. And Ben Krogman in goal tonight in place of Owen Johnson. Transfer from Appleton, Wisconsin. Ben has stepped up big in his role as the new goalkeeper in place of Owen Johnson. Played well versus Nebraska Wesleyan. And since he's been in, besides the game versus Luther. But today's a different day. New game. I believe bigger stakes on the line, obviously. I believe both teams need a win to get a berth in the national tournament. And the Loras College team did that last year, winning one game in the NCAA tournament last year up in Minnesota at St. Olaf. Trying to get there back again. Steve McCarthy in his third season got his men going. You know, he said he wanted to start off fast like the women does. Get some goals in there. Get the bench going. We know we got some guys on there that love to celebrate. They got some great celebrations over there. So we need to get a goal for the Duhawks and get this game going. As Luther sends it over into Duhawk territory. A great save by Ben Krogman. And Oquendo is fast up there for the Norse. Got to keep him contained today. Don't let him get free in space. We all know what he can do. Especially Marcos Villa, fifth year from Madrid, Spain. And a chance for the Duhawks, but no, says the goalkeeper. Jack Bell in a goalkeeper today. Wearing the black kit as the goalie in Luther. Wearing blue kits, all blue kits today. Loras wearing their new whites. I believe it says Loras Gold in the front. Purple lettering in the back. A little small for those SIDs out there. But a great thing for Luther, those big numbers in the back. We love those as an SID mind. As Luther takes control in the backfield. Send it over on the Loras territory side. Sends it over. Basinger in there. Luther still maintaining possession on their side of the 50 as they cross in and out of Loras territory. Getting in and out, and it looks like a foul on Kevin Kuchaba. So a free kick for Luther as they go into the 30-yard line. Getting the passes around, and a good attack by Taylor Sowell, freshman from Rockford, Illinois. Went to Bowling Catholic, good program up there in the Chicagoland area. That's where most of these guys are from. McCarthy loves the Chicagoans. Looks like a foul on Luther, drawn by Taylor Sowell. Got two captains on the field today, Kevin Kuchaba and Jose Cardenas. Unlike the woman with one, with Peyton McDonald. Kind of have two captains, a little different today for the men. sat down with Jared Block earlier this week and asked him about having two captains, what's the difference, and he said, just brings the team together. Kevin Kuchaba's not really a loud speaking guy, just kind of has his actions. Jose is the one kind of leading the charge for this Loras College men's soccer team. And also, Jared Block is one to watch out for. He's the tall guy, him and Brandt. And Reed McClavick. So watch those guys in the box as Jared got kind of ran over there. And in the box, and an attempt at a goal from Reed McClavick. But offside is Reed as he ran into the goalie. Hope the goalie is okay. We'll see. And the refs stopped the clock. Wow, we almost had a first goal by Reed McClavick. Like I said, showtime. He always shows up. And had kind of a wide open goal. The goalie kind of misplaced it. And then they both just kind of ran into each other. A non-violent play, just kind of ball scooped out. And Reed happened to be there, so he put in the back of the net. But offside is the ref, and ref's always right no matter what, as we know in sports. And here's another replay. Let's see. Sent in. See, kind of just came on, and Reed sent it in. And all the Duhawks are in just surprise as he called off sides. So now Luther has it now in their own territory. Closer game at this point, 0-0, unlike last time. I think Luther popped off with two goals early. I think it's going to be a little low-scoring game today as the Duhawks kind of fell apart as Felipe sends it into the Loras crowd. Fan's going to get the ball. Not for a souvenir, though. Not in Division III. Maybe D1, but not here. And out of bounds off of Luther. And a Loras throw-in. Brian Basinger is going to do the throwing duties today for Loras. Usually Jared Block, but they need Jared Block in the box. They want him to get in there and head it in for a goal like he did on Wednesday. First, the Prairie Wolves. So here we go from Ryan Basinger. Going to throw it in to the box. Watch Michael Brandt kind of getting some space. And Reed had it. Kevin had a shot chance. Looks like it's going to be a corner. So Taylor Sowell is going to take the corner up. Or maybe throw in. Looks like he's going to the corner. So unlike the women, the men's kind of have a safety option with Kevin Kuchaba on the side. Just in case Taylor doesn't really feel comfortable sending into the box. As you will, and Kevin Kuchaba sends the box, but defended by Luther well. And another shot, kind of cross in. And Kevin Kuchaba, cross, nice cross, and another kind of defense. And Reed McClavick had a chance, but no. And a foul by Reed again. Reed, they're getting chances down there. They're just not coming through, and I would say getting into the back of the net. But we still got a whole game in front of us. Hopefully get plenty more opportunities for Showtime to get in the goal. As Luther takes possession on the other side of the 50-yard line, but going back and forth. Men's play a lot different than the women. Women go, 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 go. Men kind of pass it around, make sure they get possessions in and out, want everyone to touch the ball and get positioning to make an opportunity for a goal. And sent in, but going to be out of bounds, so a goal kick for Krogman. Still a lot of fans here rooting on these Duhawks and Norse. Shout out to the Norse fans for driving down from Decorah, Iowa. Hopefully it's a little warmer down here, down South Iowa. Not colder up there. They're near the Minnesota border in Decorah, Iowa. Sent in the middle of the circle. Basinger gets it, heads it. Sowell A mini head off to the side. Gets it back to the goalie. Goalie sends it back. Basinger again with the header, and Reed Mikovic again trying to send it off to, looks like, Alice Beausoleil. Going to get in there in the mix. Going back and forth possessions. Basinger fighting for it. Kevin fighting for it. Gets it. A nice kind of dish off pass by Sowell. Beausoleil fighting for it with the Luther defender. So now Luther maintains full possession on the 35-ish, 30-yard line. Send it back to the 20. Watch out for number 28 on the right side. And now a chance for Luther. Good defending by the Loras College defense. Felipe Ramirez in there. But Luther still has half possession. Now they have full possession, getting in the corner. And gonna have a goal kick. Good defense by Alex Beausoleil. And I believe there's new ball chasers. Shout out to them, Loras College track team, helping out the Duhawks with ball chasing today. They do a fantastic job. Always love having them around. Duhawks supporting Duhawks. In the middle, Basinger. Going back and forth with headers, kind of hot potato-like. And Luther maintains possession as he sends it to Loras territory. And block with the header on the 20-yard line. Send it to Beausoleil. Beausoleil tries to send it out to Kuchaba, but the Luther defender sends it out of bounds, up the deflection. So a Jared block, throw-in. Sends it over to Reed Mikovic. Sowell has it. Fighting for it. Now he has full possession. Pass to Felipe Ramirez. And Beausoleil has it. Try to send to Reed Mikovic, but intercepted by the Luther defense. Sent it over. To Will Overberg. But defended well by Jose Cardenas. Midfield now for Luther. No foul in there. Ref's going to let him play. And now a kind of fight for the ball with Brandt and the Luther defender. Send it off to Reed Mikovic on the 20-yard line, but it's going to roll out of bounds for a Luther throw-in. Kind of back and forth with possessions here. So it's a pretty even game so far. Early stages of this one. First half, 27-39 left to go and counting. Duhawks have two shots. Norse have three. Two saves for the Duhawks and zero saves for the Norse. As Luther has it on midfield, sent it over and intercepted, but still possession by Luther as he sends it over Bing. And Krogman just sends it over. No foul in the box. Refs letting the boys play today, which is good. Don't really like a ticky-tacky game. I mean, it's the ARC Championship. Got to let the boys play. Unless it's an obvious foul. That's kind of can go either way. Don't really want to give another team an advantage over in the box area unless it's very obvious. Luther has possession, send it over again to Overbring, and Krogman will take it over, jump kind of out of the way of the Luther forward. Loras goalie's wearing red, kind of a standout color for the whites that the Loras College team has on, as Kuchaba has a 10-yard line. And avoiding Luther defenders. And a shot by Basinger. And it is over the goalpost, but through the uprights. But we're not playing football. That was earlier. So it's going to be a goal kick for Luther. The defender has it in the 20-yard line, going up to midfield-ish area. Reed McClavick defending, trying to get the ball back for the Duhawks so he can create an opportunity to score a goal. Still tied up at zero. Whoever scores first, the crowd is going to erupt. It's a very highly intense match. And it's going to be a hold on Basinger. Ref stopped the clock. Probably going to call him over to tell him no. He's going to give him a yellow. So a yellow admitted by the ref to Basinger. Kind of was holding his jersey. And that is a no-no in soccer. So now a free kick at the 36-yard line in Duhawk territory. Gonna try to set up an opportunity for Luther to get on the board as he sends it into the box. And just going to go right over the forwards of Luther. Luther kind of giving his statement to the ref, saying, hey, he grabbed me. But like I said earlier, ref's letting the boys play. So a goal kick for Krogman. Set in the middle of a circle. Going back and forth. Looks like Luther or Loras will maintain possession. Midfielder kind of took over and just got him out of the way. Now Luther has possession in the corner of the box, and Michael Brandt sends it away out of bounds. It's going to be a throw-in for Luther now. They'll throw in and have possession near the 25-yard line. Going to go back and forth to midfield. Now on midfield area for Luther possession. Herman Manzent will have assistant for number 3. Luther will throw in as well. Still kind of maintaining over here in the box area. And Felipe will send it to midfield to the Luther defender. Just trying to get it out of there and have Luther kind of maintain possession in the midfield. Just don't want him in the box. Don't want anybody to get a chance to score as he sends it near the box. Kicked out by Michael Kay. And so while fighting for the ball, Reed McClavick sending it to Kuchaba, and Kuchaba sends it over to Bosole. Bosole is going to take it and kick it to the box, and the Luther goalie, Jack Bell, is going to take over and give possession to Luther right now. And he'll throw it to Herman. Luther maintaining possession near midfield. Just going to pass it back and forth. Keep it away from the stars of the Duhawk offense. As Felipe going to try to fight for the ball now. Reed McClavick just kind of kicked out of bounds, tried to create an opportunity to get going. So a Luther throw in. And Luther's kind of maintaining his possessions over the last couple minutes. Still no score, 22-35 and counting left in the half. Now sent over out of bounds. Herman. Manzet. Manzenet, I should say. Over his head for a Loras College throw-in by Basinger. He's going to send it back to Krogman. And Krogman's just going to try to send it up to midfield near Reed McClavick, but intercepted by number 7, Okondo. He's from Minneapolis, Minnesota. A fifth year from the Twin Cities. And Luther and Loras' bodies just falling on the ground. Looks like might be a little slippery down there from today's rain. Maybe got caught up by a cleat from another player. as Luther has possession now on the 25-yard line and heading up to midfield. Reed McClavick kind of trying to get in there. So is Taylor as they have a chance, but sent too far. Try to create an opportunity for the Luther offense. So a goal kick for Krogman in the Loras College offense. Krogman sends it up near midfield, near Michael Kay and Reed McClavick. Both of them fighting for the ball with Loras or Luther defenders, but out of bounds. So another Luther throw-in. Luther kind of just maintaining possessions in their backfield 20-yard line area for the last couple moments here and there. Had some opportunities like this one, but Michael Brandt right there to stop it, and Basinger in the way with Beausoleil. And Beausoleil will try to send it up to Taylor Sowell, and they're both running for the ball at the 10-yard line. But Luther defenders kick it out to their midfielders. And out of bounds off of Kuchaba, so a Luther throw-in on their 20-yard line. McCarthy giving the men some advice over on the bench. Looks like it's going to be a foul caused by the Luther midfielder, Okundo, on Sowell. So a free kick coming up. Looks like Kevin Kuchaba going to take the free kick at the 24-yard line. Probably going to send it in for the big guys, Michael Brandt, Jared Block, and Reed McClavick. And Beausoleil, he gets in there. May not be as tall as Block and Brandt, but a free kick on the way. And the ref kind of telling Taylor, hey, got to stand here, got to stand there. And he says, play on. Kevin Kuchaba sent in the box. Looks like out of bounds off of Luther. Jared Block went for the header, must have missed it. So a throw in by Basinger. Looks like a little fighting and tugging around in there. Ref's going to stop the clock. Kind of chippy in there. Tension's running high. Ref trying to be the mediator. Beausoleil telling him, hey, you got to get in there. Just don't let the Luther defenders drag you around. I would say this part of the game in the box is kind of like the offensive lineman versus the defensive lineman in football. It's honestly a dogfight in there, just trying to get positioning to get an opportunity to score for both teams on either end. Here comes a throw-in by Basinger, and out of bounds off of Luther. So another throw-in, just a little right from the last throw-in. Still in there, still a dogfight in there. We see Jared Block getting his positioning, so Reed and Brandt throwing on the way in the box. And a shot by, looks like Michael Kay, or no, Taylor Sowell. Had a good opportunity, just wide right. So a goal kick for Luther. Had some moments down here, but Luther defense is playing well today. Now Luther sending it over into Duhok territory, but Jared Block heading it over, trying to fight for possession. Luther getting possession maintained at around midfield. Kevin Kuchaba trying to cut it off, just kind of overplayed it. So Luther has it midfield. Duhok fans getting a little, trying to get the team going. And a nice defense by Block. They're going to say out of bounds. So corner kick by Luther. Like I said earlier, here's come the dogfights in the center box. Ben Krogman trying to lead his guys, telling them where to go. Telling them, mark up your man. Can't let someone else sneak in there and get either a header or a goal shot on. So here comes the corner kick for Luther. Going to set in the box by number 10. And number 9, Marcos Villa has a shot, and he scores. So now Luther leads 1-0 in these early or mid stages through the first half. And I see replay here. Kind of a shot. He goes whoop right over and snuck in right in the left corner of the goal. So now Loras College and Luther College 1-0 in the way of Luther. Luther 1-0. The Luther fans a little more excited now that their team's up 1-0. Still got a lot of game left. And sent over by Michael Brandt. So a throw in by Luther. Luther has all the momentum now. Duhawks just trying to get back into this and silence that Luther crowd. Not much here from Luther, but they still showed out. They still drove the 2.5-hour drive. Shout out to them for showing up, showing out for this ARC championship match in Dubuque, Iowa. Villa there again. He's been all over the field, over in this area of the field, I should say. And he has it again in the box. Pass over, but deflected by Brian Basinger. Now Reed McClavick with the ball at midfield. Trying to make an opportunity out of bounds them, so throw in Loras. And, two subs coming in for the Duhawks. Looks like Lucas Sampson and Carson Woods, two main guys coming off the bench. I believe, fifth-year senior.
Number 22, Carson Woods.
Lucas Sampson and sophomore Carson Woods. Carson played a lot freshman year now. Kind of taking the role of the sixth man, or I guess 12th/13th man in soccer. Coming off the bench in a role player mode. But he can score, so watch out for him, Luther. And Basinger has another opportunity to throw it into the box. Jared Block, Michael Brandt, Kevin Kuchaba in the middle of the O, trying to get positioning to tie this game up. Throw from Basinger. And headed by the Luther defender out of bounds. So we're going to see a goal kick. Looks like Taylor Sowell is going to go over there, but Carson Woods said, here you go. So Kevin Kuchaba and Carson Woods will take this corner kick. Kevin Kuchaba, kind of the safety valve. They'll probably kick it over to him. Sent over in the box. And looks like out of bounds, Luther again, so we'll try it again with this corner kick. Stop the clock by the ref. Looks like a Luther defender might have been injured on the play. In other news around Iowa, the Iowa Hawkeyes defeat Purdue Boilermakers 24-3 in the football game today. And a corner sent by Carson Woods, defended by the Luther defenders. So another throw in for Basinger. The Hawkeyes go to 5-4 on the year for those Iowa Hawkeye football fans. University of Illinois lost to Michigan State today. Have an upset in Champaign. As Basinger sends it over to Brandt, but Luther defender gets it in. And a great save by the Luther goalkeeper. Looks like Grant was kind of signaling he went out of bounds, but must not have good diving play by the Luther goalkeeper. Luther takes over possession, sending it over into Duhok territory. Number nine. But just a kick out of bounds by Michael Brandt. Marcos Vela in there for Luther. Can't let these guys get past it because they will run and they are not slow. So out of bounds off of Loras, throw in Luther. .12:40 to go in the first half. And out of bounds off of Luther, looks like. So a goal kick by the Duhawks. Or throw-in, I should say. Throw-in for the Duhawks by Brian Basinger. To Carson Woods, who will head it over to Taylor Sowell, but Luther defender in there, and Carson Woods fights for the ball around midfield with Felipe Ramirez. But Luther maintains possession as they pass it back to the goalkeeper. Just trying to get his offense set up. Luther kind of maintaining possession over this last 20 minutes or so. Around the 40 to the 20-yard line. Those three defenders, center back, left back, and right back. Around midfield, Luther still in the circle. Going back and forth, Luther defenders, midfielder, they're still the defenders, so just kind of getting their forwards and midfielders set up for an opportunity to get open. But Loras defending well in this part of the field so far. Only giving up one goal so far, but it was from a corner kick. Going into the Duhawk 20-yard line-ish. Carson Woods sending it back. Looks like a foul on Luther, so free kick for Loras. Jose Cardenas will take it. Going back and forth in possession, Luther trying to take it over. Looks like they will. But Taylor Sowell and Kevin Kuchaba and Carson Woods fighting for it. So now just about to be the 10-minute mark left in this half. Only 1-0. Luther with four shots. Duhawks with four shots. Two saves and one save. It's a pretty even game so far in this ARC championship match. Luther still maintaining possession on their side of the 50. Now by midfield. And back again. He's trying to get the offense set up. Almost interception by Michael Kay, but they're going to call a foul on him. Looks like some chirping going on down there. A lot different from the women's game, as the Loras Cowles women's team dominated Simpson today. Kind of a different game so far. If you like defense, this is the game for you so far in this game. An opportunity by the Luther forward. Sends it in, but blocked by the Loras College defense. So Taylor has it now around the 20-yard line. And a foul caused by the Luther midfielder. And Taylor is down as of right now, looking like he's holding that ankle. So now a free kick coming from Loras. For those baseball fans out there, Astros and Phillies, top 5, 0-0. Game 6 of the World Series for those baseball fans out there. We're either going to see a championship crowned or a Game 7 tomorrow night. As Loras tries to get some offense down at their own box, but Luther has possessions at the 35-yard line. Looks like it's going to be out of bounds, so a throw in Loras. Sub in for Luther as they have a throw-in. Basinger with the header, trying to get possession to Kevin Kuchaba, with the Luther midfielder sends it over to Newhawk territory. Michael Kay and Aquindo trying to fight for possession here. And a flop. But they call a foul on Loras, or on Luther, I guess. So a free kick for Loras as they send it into Luther territory. Kevin Kuchaba trying to get possession over there. Now we hear the bench of Luther kind of getting this game. I mean, it's a whole team game. You got to have the bench cheering for your guys on the field. As Luther has a chance, send it over in the middle. And a shot attempt by the Luther midfielder. Now Luther maintains possession around the midfield mark. Still maintaining possession on their side of the 50-yard line with Luther, but they take it in over in Loras territory. Luther had a chance to try to cross it. Looks like it's going to be out of bounds off of Loras, so a Luther throw-in now. Trying to get in to the box for an opportunity, and a cross opportunity, but headed by Michael Kay. And Kevin Kuchaba kind of just get it out of there. But Luther gets to maintain the possession, but fighting for it is Taylor Sowell. Kind of going back and forth possessions here. Now in the right corner is Luther. And a shot opportunity blocked by Jose Cardenas. Luther has the ball around midfield, getting an opportunity for their offense to get set up for an opportunity to score and get another goal on the board. Looks like two Luther subs coming in and a Loras substitution. Looks like Noah Reed in for Michael Kay. So now Loras has possession in the box area. Reed McClavick, or I should say Kevin Kuchaba, on the other side of the field trying to make a header opportunity, but The Luther goalkeeper has the ball, kind of passes off to his right back. So Noah Reed, a sophomore from Indiana, just checked in for the Duhawks. Kind of a bench player as well, but comes off in the game, plays about 10 or 15 minutes per game in his sophomore campaign. As Taylor Solwell tries to fight for the ball. And Luther kind of driving in, but Block says no sir, kind of kicks it out, but Luther still maintaining possession, has had most of the possession this half, as there's 2:47 and counting left in the first half. Luther sent it over on the other side of the field to Herman. The fight for the ball. Job by Noah Reed. Sent it over in the middle to Taylor Sowell. He has a man to beat. And it looks like it's no play by the ref. So now Luther has possession but sent in over midfield. And Felipe tried to save it out of bounds. Kicked it over to the Luther defender but lets the goalkeeper get it. To maintain possession. Kind of had a scoring opportunity there, just didn't get the call. And now Sowell trying to kick the ball out of the goalie's hands. Now the goalkeeper throws it over to the left side to Herman. Kicks it over into Loras territory. Trying to save it out of bounds, and he does, but they're going to call it out. So a throw in by Loras. Noah Reed looking like he's going to take it. Oh, no, hand it off to Jose Cardenas. Kind of a run in there with Taylor Sowell in the midfielder for Luther. But a no play by the ref. Sends it back to the goalie again.
1 minute remaining in the half.
And a 1 minute mark left in this half. Luther still up 1-0. Good game so far today in the Rock Bowl. Thanks for those for joining online, watching, and supporting the Luther Norse and the Loras Cowles Duhawks on Duhawk Network. And Block in there trying to get it out. Draws a foul by the Luther forward. So a free kick going to be taken by Krogman with 27 seconds in remaining in this first half. And a foul by Luther, can be caused by Basinger. 15 seconds and counting, gonna have to go fast. Michael Brandt trying to get his guys in the box. 10 seconds remaining. Sends it in, but Luther declines it and sends it back. So looks like it's just gonna be tied at half. So that's the half, and it is 1-0 Norse.
Loras
Cowles 0, Luther North 1, 5 shots to 6 shots, 2 saves to 1 save. Pretty even game so far today in the Rock Bowl. And your second half coming up right after this. Calderson from Minnesota, a junior at Luther. So throw in from for Luther. Kevin Kuchaba defending him well. Now goes back to the goalkeeper. And Taylor Sowell and Felipe kind of gaining ground on him, but a throw in for Luther. So now he throws it in on the 20-yard line in Luther territory. Good chip shot, 2:28. But going back to the goalie, trying to set up some more offense for Luther. Bosola in there, Jared Block in there, trying to get possession for the Dewhawks. As Jared Block sent it over into, looks like a foul on Taylor Sowell. Don't really know that call. Kind of jumped over him. So foul on Loras. Free kick for Luther. Sends it over to the midfield mark. Now into the Loras territory. And a chance for Luther. Coming in, but out of bounds. So goal kick. Kind of broke free there, trying to get an opportunity to get this game to 2-0 for Luther as the 41-minute mark has been upon us. Loras trying to get on the board to tie this game up and either get another one or send it to OT. Jared Block going into Luther territory with Beausoleil and Brian Basinger in the mix. Now Reed McClavick fighting for the ball, gets possession. Try to send it over to Taylor Sowell or Felipe Ramirez. But the goalkeeper gathers it up and sends it over to his right back. And Luther has possession now. Luther still having possession. Looks like it's going to go out of bounds for a Jared Block and Loras College throw-in. Basinger heading it over to Reed McClavick. Reed McClavick and Basinger trying to get possession, but Luther kicks it over to midfield. Felipe or Jose Cardenas heads it over to the Loras or Luther defender. What a mix-up. Looks like it's going to be a foul on Basinger. Ref trying to call it back. Looks like the ref kind of talked to Reed McClavick over there. He has said some words. This game's getting a little more chippy as the game goes on, but the refs, like I said earlier, letting the boys play. And now Michael Kay sending it over to the midfield mark with Taylor Sowell. Has a one-on-four trying to get possession, but Luther takes over and has good defense with Jared Block. And Michael Brandt defending it well on their own side of the 50. Basinger has the ball. Kind of gets Felipe in the back. Luther has possession. Luther takes their time with these possessions, just trying to, they already have the lead, so they're trying to, you know, get something set up, giving their team the best opportunity to score, not really taking any chances, just kind of going back and forth, setting up the offense. So while Luther kind of has an offensive opportunity as of right now, but Felipe stepping in there and defending it well, and Reed McClavick trying to get possession over there by the 30-yard line with Taylor Sowell in positioning, and Jose Cardenas flips it over to Brian Basinger with Taylor Soil and Kevin Kuchaba. Kind of going ping pong style possession here. And out of bounds on Luther, so a Jared Block throw in. And for those baseball fans, Phillies take the lead in the bottom of the sixth inning in Houston. Good game going on down there in Houston, Texas. But we're focused on the ARC championship match between Loras College and the Luther Norse. Winner gets the ARC championship and a NCAA playoff berth. Both of these teams can make a big run in the national tournament. Just whatever team gets hot. As we know, in every NCAA tournament, teams and players that get hot around that time usually show out and bring home a national title for their college. Around midfield, Loras trying to maintain possession. And Reed McClavick getting in pursuit of the ball, but the Luther defenders have it. And out of bounds off of Reed McClavick, so a Luther throw-in. Around midfield, Michael Brandt heads it over to Michael Kay. Michael Kay kind of arguing, kind of hit him in the back. And Jared Block sending it over to Beausoleil, but the Luther defenders intercepted again. And Kevin Kuchaba, Michael Kay fighting over the ball, trying to get position back for the Duhawks. Trying to tie this game up 1-0 as it out of bounds off of Kuchaba. So, hey, another Luther throw-in with 35 minutes to go in this second half. Still a pretty even game on the scorecards. Luther just with one extra shot. And that one extra shot may be the difference maker in today's game. Luther had an opportunity, just overshot his midfielder slash forward. So a throw in for Loras. Reed McClavick there, just not in time for the Luther midfielder. Block fighting over the ball. Kondo with a opportunity, but kind of pass it out and intercepted by Beausoleil. But Luther still has the possession on the 30-yard line going towards the goal. The shot blocked by Felipe Ramirez. Okondo again. And a shot blocked. Looks like off of Luther, so a throw-in for Loras. Number 20 over there. Javier Valles has an opportunity, but a missed opportunity by Will Overberg. He's an Iowa native from Inky, Iowa. A senior at Luther College. Trying to get his team into the playoffs and the NCAA tournament. Basinger fighting the ball with Kuchaba, and they have it. A 3-on-4. Kevin sends it over the head of the Luther defender. Taylor Soil in pursuit, kicks out of bounds. Looks like it's going to be a corner kick, but a man down for Luther. Looks like they're going to stop the clock and bring out the trainer. In other news, for those Fighting Irish fans, in the fourth quarter, Clemson Tigers versus the Irish of Notre Dame. Notre Dame leading them 7-28. A big upset around college football.
Yellow card issued to number 14, Taylor Sowell.
And so Taylor Sowell gets her yellow card by the ref. But I think it's still going to be a corner kick for the Dewhawks. Trying to tie this game up at one. Let's see if they can do it. So it looks like he's going to pass it off to Kuchaba for a cross attempt. Looks like they're trying to get the number 24 in Luther to stand behind the line. Looks like he's in front of it. So a cross attempt from Kuchaba. And in there is Brandon Block. An attempt by Michael Kay into the area, and Block just overshot it on the goalpost. So gonna be a goal kick by Luther. Great opportunity for Loras to tie this game up. Let's see a replay. Michael Kay crosses it in. Jared Block climbs the ladder, tried to head it. He had an opportunity, but just a little bit too high. So now Luther has possession in their own box with Dewhawks pursuing on the ball. Felipe Ramirez trying to head it over. Now Luther has possession. Here comes Will Overberg. Gonna have to cross it in to get a goal in here, or he's gonna shoot it himself. Crossing number 24, mishap. And another shot by Villas. But deflected by, looks like, either Kuchaba or Michael Kay. So it looks like it's probably gonna be a corner for Luther. Luther fans getting into it. They know momentum's on their side, trying to put the game up 2-0. So in the corner now. Has a shot opportunity. And just kind of gets caught up. So another goal kick for Krogman. Had an opportunity there. Just defenders for Loras got in the mix to make sure he never got a shot off. Now in the circle for Kuchaba, trying to get in the middle of there for Basinger. And Sowell has it. Going into the corner, looks like it's going to be a throw-in for Loras. Loras kind of has to go a little faster here. They don't want to be a little behind now on this momentum. Throw-in by Basinger, up in the air, headed by the Luther defender, and he just kicks it out to Jose Cardenas, and a miss, kind of ran into each other, so a throw-in for Loras. Basinger with the ball, now looks like Felipe, and it's just going to roll all the way down to Krogman on the 10-yard line, probably going to just kick it out. So a boot by Krogman down to the 35-yard line with Luther having the ball. A foul on Sowell. Loras bench not happy about that one. Kind of went for the ball. Just kind of fell over as Rick McClavick is in pursuit of the ball. Back okay with the header on the 20-yard line and block. And Felipe, a three-header. Now just in Luther territory. But the goal kicker kicks it away. Nice play by Oquendo. Nice play by Block, too. Trying to get it to stay in bounds. And Kuchaba gets it to Reed McClavick, he has a chance. Pass it over to himself, but defended well by the Luther defender. And Bosley has it. Cross it over to Felipe. And Sowell now has it. Pass it over to Ryan Basinger, or Michael Kay, I should say. Crosses it in to Kuchaba. And kind of hit his back shoulder, so now it's going to go out of bounds. But they're going to say it's off Luther, so a Loras throw-in. This game is going to come down to the wire. Someone needs a score here to kind of get things going. Still 1-0, 28 minutes to go in this game. Throw-in by Basinger. And a Luther defender heads it. Looks like Basinger is going to try to know. He's going to pass it to Michael Kay. Okay, he's going to send it into the box. We have guys there. And it's going to go in. No, it's not. It's going to hit the crossbar. And now a defense. Good defense by Luther. They had an open goal. And another cross into the goal. And they stop the clock for a man down. Looks like it's going to be Taylor Sowell. Let's see that again. Good cross. Michael Brandt hit it in. And Kuchaba almost had it, but it hit off the left post. Had two opportunities to tie this game up. So now after that injury report, we're going to have some play on by the ref, a drop ball by the head ref. And a fight for the ball in midfield area with Basinger and a good defense by Jose Cardenas. Ben Krogman just going to pick it up and trying to send it over to midfield area. Still 1-0, 27 minutes left. A decent amount of time in this game for Loras or Luther to score. Loras trying to tie this game up. Good move by Michael Kay. Looks like both benches are kind of heavy talkers in this game. Trying to get them going, trying to get the fans, the players hyped up, even though they're kind of in the zone right now. And across into the box, and another great play by the Luther defenders, just kind of getting in there and not letting the Loras, you know, main scores to get a chance and tie this game up. Props to both defenses. Only one goal scored so far in this game. Unlike the women's game where we're seven goals total. A lot different game in the men's game. Looks like there's going to be two subs, one for Loras, one for Luther. And I think that's Carson Woods down there. Trying to get his possession going, and a cross by Basinger into Reed. And he's going to bicycle kick it way, way left. Almost, just trying to get something started for the Loras College. And let's take another look at this. Across in to the box. Oh, it's going to be off two Luther defenders. So they really got in there. Michael Brandt really didn't get a chance to ever get a body part, leg or head on it. So good plays by the Luther defense.
The Duhawks, number 20, Diego Rodriguez.
Diego Rodriguez in.
The Norris, number 45, Max Dorhold.
Max Dorhold in there for Luther as well. Checking into this middle part of the game. Sent back to the goalie. Down to midfield with the Luther guy heading it. Michael Brandt is going to send it back to Krogman. And he'll send it. Try to send it over to Kuchaba. Intercepted by the Luther midfielder. And Block trying to get in there. Trying to fight to get back possession. Defending him well. Luther midfielder making the moves on Block. Block's really not letting him get any space to go inside on him. A good pass by him to get to the forward. And back now to the right back. Now they'll play this cat and mouse game. John, I'll let Loras get him up. And looks like it's going to be a foul on Felipe Ramirez. Cause Ben number 3, Herman Manizan. So now a free kick, and it's going to go back to the center back. Back now to Herman. Like I said, a cat and mouse game for Luther. When they trying to get a possession to go, as the Luther midfielder kind of told his guys, hey, calm down, we got this. Let's just take our possessions one at a time. Don't let Loras get in there and intercept the ball and have them take possession. Loras doing all they can to fight for possession. And it looks like it's going to be a shot opportunity. Way wide and way up top. Missed both the goal and the goal post for football, so no good. And these guys have, all these guys have powerful strikes, can score from really anywhere inside the 20-yard line. So watch out. Could be a strike from anywhere. So an opportunity for Luther going into the corner and just going to roll out of bounds. So looks like going to be a goal kick for Krogman. Krogman sends it into the middle. No play by the ref. Kind of got shoved down to the ground by the Luther midfielder. Bosley with the ball around the 40-yard line. Defended well by the Luther midfielder. Facundo's making plays all night long. Just kind of in and out. He's honestly super quick. Loras is kind of having a hard time defending him, which is maybe why they're down 1-0. Sampson with the header. A little 2-yard header. Trying to get it out. Quindo kind of get it. Luther has an opportunity here. Both teams going at it. They're talking, not talking towards them, but just about the game. Both teams playing really hard. I'll give it to them. They're playing hard. Both teams really want a playoff berth in the NCAA tournament. So it's a good, intense, hard-fought game so far with 21 minutes to go in the game. Both teams love to win. Both good programs in the ARC. Now some talking from Jared Block. As number seven, Aquino's down. And Sampson tries to get it in, but defended well. So now they're going to stop the clock here for an injured player, Okundo. Looks like he's going to have a substitution coming in for him.
Come on, let's score that way.
So now the trainer for Luther is coming out to the midfield area to see how Aquino's doing. That's a player Luther does not need to lose right now, as they are up 1-0.
Into the game for the Norse, number 13, Ben Beinzinger.
Now in the game, number 13, Ben Beinzinger. So a drop ball for the referee, making a sprint down to midfield. He's been working all night long. Refing a good game so far. I'll give him that. It's kind of hard with these two very dominant programs. Both teams are very intense on both sides of the ball. And they're both fighting for something very important for their program. Every program fights for a conference championship tournament win.
Number 8, Kevin Kuchaba.
The ref's doing a great job officiating this game so far, with 20-20 left in the game and a goal kick for Luther as the ball rolls out of bounds. Diego just tried to get a shot off, but ball rolled a little too fast for him. All these guys are fast, they're just shooting them past them and not getting the opportunities they want. Ball midfield area. Beckel Brandt heads it back to midfield for Loras to get some possession off the ref. But there was a foul, so didn't really matter that the ref came into play. At this point, we see the ref, he might want some action in this game. But he's the officiator for today's match, and so Loras will have free kick, and they have it at the 40-yard line. Jared Block. Opportunity for Sampson, keeping it in bounds in the corner. But he misplayed it, and it bounced over. And a throw-in for Luther. So Carson Woods has it in the box, trying to send it in the middle area. Beisinger has it, but the Luther defender kicks it out. So right back to Ben Krogman. Sends it over to Beisinger, trying to get it over to Michael Kay, but wasn't enough. So now a foul called by the ref, but it's the Luther defender that caused it. And now Felipe has a free kick near the 50-yard line. Going to try to maybe send it in to the box, and he does. Jared Block has almost an attempted shot, but it rolled out of bounds. Now a goal kick for Luther. Still 1-0 with 18 exactly minutes left to go in this match. And like I said earlier, winner gets the ARC Championship Tournament Trophy and a NCAA berth. Kevin Kuchaba has the ball, passed it over to Carson Woods. Carson Woods gives it to number 20, Diego Rodriguez. And it looks like it's going to be another goal kick for Luther. And a sub for Loras as Reed McClavick and Taylor Sowell come back in this game. Great job by Carson Woods and Diego Rodriguez to play their roles. Loras is a middle on the younger side team. Got a decent amount of seniors, but a lot of people on the bench are younger and going to be future stars in this Loras College program. And they fight off by Jared Block, but that will go out of bounds for a Luther throw-in. Another sub for Luther as number 7 comes back in this game. A key point in this game as he comes back into the match. Tries to get Luther an extending goal, 2-0, but right now it is 1-0. So another Luther throw-in at the 20-yard line area-ish. And he's going to throw it to number 9 in the corner. Good play by Jared Block. Now Luther has the ball around the 30-yard line, trying to make an opportunity for them to score. I'm going to go back to the cat and mouse game with McClavick and Felipe Ramirez. And another foul by Loras Basinger. Kind of a, just got caught up. No violence. Most of these fouls are non-violent. Just kind of caught up, but it is a foul. So now Luther will have a free kick on the 25-yard line. Probably going to send it in the box. A little dogfight down there with Block and Basinger. And Krogman's going to have the ball. Going to bounce it in the air. But he has possession. So now going to try to get the Loras College offense going. Missed kick by the Luther defender. Felipe has it at round midfield, but kicked out by the midfielder of Luther. And there it goes, number 7, but overshot again. So a Loras College throw-in. Another throw-in for Loras. To Felipe, sending it over to Sampson. Has an opportunity, but a great call up by the Luther goalie. Good job to intercept that one. Sampson had an opportunity, just a little too far to the right for the goalie keeper to straggle it up. So now sent over to the Loras territory. Sampson has it though. And McClavick has it, fighting for the possession. Good job by the Luther defender. And another foul by McClavick. Ref stopping the clock. Gonna see what's going on down there. Making sure the free kick spot is correct, and it is. So play on, says the ref. Sends it over to the midfield area with Basinger. Heading it over to Kevin Kachaba. And Reed McClavick in the middle of the three people for Luther. And Jose Cardenas heads it to number 7. Almost an opportunity, but Jared Block blocks it again. So Sampson has it around the 30-yard line. Has it over for Kevin Kachaba. Still has it over. Going to pass it over to Michael Kay in the corner. Trying to probably cross it. Has a cross opportunity, but defended well by Luther defender. But a goal or a corner kick for Loras. Gonna see if they're gonna do this. Yep, same safety valve. I'm no soccer player, but man, I would kick it right into the center. See if we can get an opportunity for one of those big guys to get in there and head it in for a goal. Let's see, yep. A miss hit by Kuchaba, but good thing for Loras off the Luther defender. So going to try it again. Get it in there for Loras. Chaba's going to center it in. And off the Luther defender again. So another corner kick. Crossed in by Kuchaba. Ball's in the air. Time is stopped by the ref. Some tussling going down in there. It's going to be a yellow card issued by one of those players down there. This game's getting a little chippy as it goes on. Another a yellow card issued to Reed McClavick. So here's a replay. So Kevin crosses it in off the Luther defender up in the air, and Reed just tries to get it in but ran into the goalie. So it's going to be yellow on Reed as a Luther defender or goalkeeper sends it to the middle of the field. Loras trying to get on the board. 1-0 game with 11:55 and counting left in this match. Like I said, it's going down to the wire here. Luther has it in the box. Trying to cross it, but out of bounds off of Brandt. So a throw in for Luther. Throw in by Luther into the S. Loras. Block and Basinger there. Gonna be off of Loras, so a corner kick for Luther, as we see a couple subs going to come in for the Dewhawks. So Loras trying to defend. Luther trying to get in another goal to extend their lead by two. Crossing it in. Good defense by Krogman. Bounced it out. And Luther defender is just going to try to get a corner kick, and they do. So a corner kick coming up for Luther. Now kick out to the Luther forward on the corner of the box. Going to now play back. Trying to set up an opportunity for Luther. Into the box. And a header by number 24. But over the goal. Almost another goal for Luther. It looks like Bosolai coming in. Now Kyler Donovan checking in for the first time today. Ethan Kelly as well in the game. Kyler Donovan kind of nursing an injury, but you know what? It's for a good cause, so he's going to play through it and check in the late stages of this game. Going to try to get his Dewhawks on the board. Michael Kay in the corner, but getting defended by the Luther defender. Trying to get him off him. Now another Luther defender coming in pursuit, and they kick it out. And another foul on Taylor Sowell. So a free kick coming up for Luther as 9 minutes left in this game. Number 13 for Luther, trailing him. And a goal kick going to be issued by the ref. So Ben Krogman's going to try to get the Duhawk offense going again as 8:36 and counting left in this ballgame. Felipe Ramirez in the middle with Kyle Donovan. And Michael Kay trying to defend the Luther forwards. Nice defense by Krogman. They're going to stop the clock. Looks like the Luther defender's getting a little, has hurt. And now we're back, so off an injury report. I hope he's okay. I think he twisted his ankle pretty bad. Hope that Luther athlete is just fine, but Loras trying to score here. Have it in the middle. Try to send it in the middle. Never like to see injured players in any game, either team. But we play on. And I think he's going to root for his team on the sidelines. Never want to see a player go down, especially a star player like that guy. Now, Loras trying to get possession of the ball here, fighting for the ball. Turning into a rubber match here. Is out of bounds, and it's going to be a throw in Luther. With 7 minutes and counting left in this match. Good play by Michael Brandt, trying to send it away. And a throw in by Luther, but out of bounds. Good play by Ethan Kelly. Trying to send it away, but Luther intercepts it. Still playing cat and mouse game. Trying to just get away from the defenders. Going to try to take a shot here. 3-on-3 now for Luther. Defenders come in, so now 3-on-4. Michael Brandt defending him well. Here comes Block. Shot off. Good play by Ben Krogman. Saving that ball from going in the net. And a sent off by, looks like, either Michael Brandt. So if Loras throw in, Ethan Kelly's going to take it in. Stephen McCarthy trying to get his boys going. Trying to get this game all tied up. Michael Brandt with the ball. And a foul by the Luther defender. Nearing the 5-minute mark. 5:20 left to go. Ref stopped the clock for a free kick. Yellow issued to a Luther player. Don't know who it is.
Yellow card issued to number 25, William Valentine.
So in my ear, it looks like number 25. Pat got the yellow card. A lot of yellow cards in this game. Very chippy match so far. Like I said, both teams fighting for a playoff berth in the NCAA tournament and the ARC championship trophy. A big accomplishment for either program and for any team in the ARC trying to get that trophy. Sent into the box. And way offline to the left by Kevin Kuchaba. So a goal kick by Luther with 5:11 left in this game. Getting down to the wire. Loras needs to get going. They want to tie this game up. Luther playing good defense. So is Loras. Haven't been a goal scored in the second half so far. It was in the middle stages of the first half where the only lone goal was scored in this game. Now we'll play near the top of the box. Now into the box. A shot and scooped up by Krogman. Good play by the Loras goalie. Going to send it over in the midfield area. Passed it, actually. Wow, what a boot. Into the Luther defender. Sends it back and forth. Ping pong ball. Here we go. Brandt trying to get possession. Luther midfielder slash forward gets it going. So now it's going to be a corner kick for Luther. And Luther kind of taking their time here. Trying to stall this clock out with four minutes left to go in this game. Good job by Felipe Ramirez to get it out. Time's ticking for both teams now. Trying to get another goal on either side. So going to be a goal kick for Loras. Loras kind of going to be in hot pursuit here as they try to get a goal tying goal. Jared Block in the middle with Brandt. But good defense by the Luther defense. But Ramirez picks it up. Trying to be in the corner, maybe trying to get an opportunity for the Loras College offense in the box. But sent out by the Luther defense. But Brandt picks it up at midfield, heads it over to Felipe Ramirez. Seems like there's always some sort of guy in the blue with the ball. Intercepted again. Like I said, always someone with the blue has the ball. A matter of 30 seconds or less. That's been a key for the Luther Norse today, just getting on the ball anytime they can. Jared Block with the ball. Pass to Felipe Ramirez, trying to get in the box. Kyler Donovan has the ball past the block. They try to get it in. And a looks like off the Luther defender, but then off Kevin Kuchaba. So it's going to be a goal kick. Had another opportunity for Loras to tie this game up with 2 minutes to go. Let's see a replay here. Jared Block sends it into the box. You see Kevin Kuchaba. Yeah, off, oh, so off Taylor so well. Almost an opportunity for Loras to get in to the scoring column. At midfield, 1:39 remaining in this game. Luther has it on their Loras side of the field. Taylor Sowell trying to fight for the ball at midfield. Luther has it. Going to go back to their midfielders. Block trying to intercept it. Another opportunity for Luther here. Trying to pass it out to number 10. Going right or left. And he chooses left. Going to pass it back to his midfielder. With 1:09 remaining in this game. Loras has a throw-in. Going to throw it out to Kyler Donovan. Save it in. Inbounds. And Beausoleil, with 1 minute remaining now in this game. Rogman sends the midfield, but Luther defenders are there. So 42 seconds and counting in this game. Card issued to a Loras player with 25 seconds left in this game. Loras trying to get anything they can to tie this game up. Still 1-0. Ten seconds to go. So now 5 seconds to go. Looks like Luther's going to win this game and take the ARC championship and have a playoff berth. Good, hard-fought game, but the Luther Norse take the ARC and they will have a playoff berth. So the final score of this game, DeHawks 0, Luther Norse 1. Congratulations to the Luther College Norse on their ARC championship. And they will have a chance to compete for the national title in the NCAA playoffs.